Hi, I'm Go Number 4 from the future with strange lighting. In this video, me and Blondskunk are going to be walking through and kind of judging and kind of looking at some builds from a building contest that I arranged for the community a while back. This building contest was free for anyone to join, so we're going to see all sorts of people in here building some awesome stuff. And the prize for the building contest was that we were going to take the winner's build and we were going to use the theme, use the palette, use the ideas to make a bigger community project that anyone can join. So that's coming up really soon. If you're interested in joining a big community build with some direction, like a little bit of a team build situation, feel free to hop in the Discord in the link down below. Without further ado, I'm gonna leave you with the video. There you go, here's the video. Somebody's punching the heck out of me in there.
Hello, what is happening?
Hi, Blondskunk, how are you doing?
I'm doing great, how are you?
I can't hear with all the punching going on.
No, there's too much punching. What the heck? But the plan here is that me and Blondskunk are just gonna kind of, I don't know, walk around these plots and have a look at them.
Just have a gander, have a look at all these beautiful, magnificent builds that everybody's put together.
They're so good. Like, I'm super impressed by everybody. There's so many.
I'd be lying if I didn't say I already had a little bit of a sneak peek already, but it's so great.
So what we're doing is basically we're just having a look, and like I've stated before, we are mostly looking for like a good theme, a good palette, a good story behind the build, something that can look awesome the way it is, but also kind of be scaled up into a bigger project, since the winning plot is going to be the basis for our big community project later. All right, so let's start with this one. This is actually Jace's plot. His name is it's not Jace's.
Jace's.
Jace. He is an Instagrammer that I've followed for a while. He's great.
Mm-hmm. I'm like looking at this already, and I can already feel like there's like, this is like an older town, right? This is, and there's like drones coming in, they're scoping out this like ancient landscape.
It's a beautiful medieval village. What are your first impressions here? Like, what's the first thing you think about when you see this plot?
There's a lot of life here and a lot of like just greenery and beautifulness. I was saying this before. I'm like, how many trees can you fit on the one plot and still make it look so good? Wow. Yeah, I love it. I think it's fantastic.
Part of the rules were to include at least two 1.17 textures. So they use the dripstone in the wooden walls. Also, they of course got the deep slate foundation here, which is bound to look good.
Oh, it's so good.
Definitely. Death Hunt is hiding. Okay, hi, there's a dragon there. It's also, we haven't really mentioned like the dynamic shapes of all these houses. They are all kinds of diagonal in ways I don't really understand.
These roofs are a bit, you know, all over the place. Like, they don't really have, like, a set shape. You know how it doesn't just step up? It's like, oh, we're going to go here. We're going to go there. Like you said, dynamic. It's very nice. We'll give you 5 cake.
Definitely. We'll give that 5 cakes. 5 and whatever this is. Sorry. Like, somebody ate it.
I got a little hungry.
All right, let's move on then to this one. We had rules for not building outside of the plot, but these guys have kind of stitched their plots together with this power line. I think it looks awesome. So this is Big Mac Builds on Instagram. Fantastic, fantastic builder. This build, man, there is a lot going on.
Terracotta, glazed terracotta just in the back here. But when you stand back, it's like, yeah, that works. Like, you wouldn't think about it, but it works. I just love the like apocalyptic feel going on here. Oh, it's so wonderful.
It's definitely some kind of dystopian future, this, you know? So
right.
It kind of feels like a container house. Like, it's been like put together, scrambled together with different containers or structures, you know? So the shapes here are kind of simple, which is the interesting part. Like, rectangles put together, but it still feels very complex.
Yeah, it's definitely more on the complex side. I would definitely say that for sure.
Yeah. This is a style that I'm so unfamiliar with. I don't really know what to say. It just looks really, really good.
It's very refreshing as well. I will say that.
Definitely.
It's very, because it's not like your typical fantasy style, you know, or a futuristic style. It's just a refreshing build.
And also, like, big props to making purr-purr work. Purr-purr is like a really hard block to work with.
Absolutely.
Oh, you gave this a lot of cakes. That's pretty sick, dude.
Okay, moving on
from this build. This is great, Big Mac. We're moving to this next one, and this is a build by Zasp, which is also, he's also an Instagrammer.
A lot of Instagrammers.
Great at, like, gradients and castle structures, which I think really shows in this build.
Oh, screw the castles. Come look at the trees in the back. Look at these things.
Beautiful.
The dripstone.
Oh, the dripstone trunk, dude.
10
that's
out of 10.
Actually, 10 out of 10 tree.
your simple, nice textured castle style. And
it's really good. I've been heavily inspired by Zasp and his gradient work.
Right.
For the last half a year. He's great. It's just a basic medieval rectangle style house. And then these little turret towers hanging out on all the corners just adds infinite amounts of interest. And it just looks really sick.
it's a basic shape, but there's the gradients make it pop. It's
definitely.
Oh, it's wonderful.
This gradient here with the kind of beigeish to orangey gradients on this building is very cool. But I think I almost like this stone one even more because it's so subtle, but like it really works. If you squint here,
I'm squinting.
Like it just feels like the light hits the building from the top, you know.
It reminds me of home, you know.
Give all the cakes, definitely.
Many cakes.
This is just something we threw together. I'm pretty happy with it. But then
I think
when people came in here and started building all these amazing things, I instantly felt like I'm not a good builder anymore. But I'm happy with the little cliffs. So there we go. We're moving on to this one. This is Spunzus. What would you say about this guy right here?
I'm just blown away about all the lovely just foliage everywhere. I love it. It's got moss integrated into the roof and grass. Like you see grass roofs from time to time, but moss roofs.
Moss roofs. That's something else. Oh, he even got some sea pickles in here. Yeah, this is you know what this reminds me of? This reminds me a little bit of Pearlescent Moon. The way the 45
degree... I was going to say the same thing.
Yeah, mm-hmm. The 45 degree diagonal, the grassy roofs. I'm loving all these like spruce signs and spruce trapdoors and barrels and stuff to add detail to the wooden parts. Ooh, there's a little blacksmith area back here. This is really nice.
And the tuff.
I like this
forge.
You have
the tuff in here as well.
Yeah, the tuff. Yeah.
Cake in time.
Yeah, definitely. Cake this guy.
Not a half a cake. We'll give all the cake. There we go.
Yeah,
lovely.
So, infinite cakes. Here's one by Allgamer. I don't think this guy's finished.
There's a bit of a drag in the back.
Hold on.
Is there any system for the cakes?
No, there's no system for the cakes.
Enjoy.
You just get cake. this is Broken Pixel.
Broken Pixel.
SK, I think, on Instagram.
Mm-hmm.
This is sick.
Wow. This just reminds me of, like, if the Nether or the End were to take over the overworld, and this is what happened. The dragon reminds me of, like, the Nether dragon, if there was ever a thing.
If there was ever a Nether dragon. Yeah. Oh, man. But, yeah, this is just insanely cool. Like, there is a really creative, they've really made a biome of their own, you know?
I always love the fog effect, too. That's always a good thing with the glass.
We like the fog effect. And also I really like how these like towers or whatever are kind of almost built into the terrain. And
they're
I think this
candles at the top here too.
And have you noticed how like the whole plot is basically a gradient up? So we start at like
it's a
really
whole
black,
thing going
and then,
all the way up.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, all the way up here you get the deep slate and then you go into is this cyan terracotta? Yeah.
And tough. Yeah.
I really like that. And the gradients in the
well
roofs
made.
Look great as well.
So many
made. Cakes. So many. Yeah. Give them the cakes,
lots.
You know? I think we're just progressively going to give more and more cakes. Bro, this is really good, Broken Pixel. This is so good.
Yeah, well done.
I think this is Mario's plot, but he never built anything.
Jeez, so, he's after like
yeah,
members.
Mario, get out lazy. Of here, Mario. Okay, we move on to this. Bamu, first of all, I don't think this is finished, right? No. Sketched out, but not.
And you got the wool
finished.
Here too.
Yeah.
The idea, like the little beach theme, right? On the beach, like an Italian shore, maybe.
Yeah. But I love all the color and texture here in the yes. water and on the beach.
Yes.
Oh, the shells on the beach and a little book, you know? Maybe you're reading
yeah.
your book.
Yeah. This one's all about the small details.
Yeah. It's very much like there's a lot of tiny depth, you know?
Right.
Well done. Let's move on to Admirables then. Admirables, also one of the Instagram people, you know? Fantastic builder.
Using just, the drip on the stumps. Oof.
Yes, that's genius. I was just about to say, Admirables is just so good at all like the small little details of terraforming.
You just walk. You, this is a plot you want to walk slowly through.
Yeah, and definitely.
Just take in everything.
He's not afraid to use slabs underwater here as well to get a good shape underwater. You don't really right, usually right. do that, right? And this tree stump that's fallen over looks insanely yes. good. Yeah, this is a really good plot. We haven't even taken a look at the structure yet.
Which has got building. Interior, by the way. Well done.
Oh, well done. These are some nice cool. interiors. I like this little balcony. What?
Come here, look at this. There's candles on top of this bush. Ooh. Isn't that just like a cool little detail?
That's a nice. Really cool little detail.
Bye, everybody. Seems stay down there.
Look at this shelving unit up here. You
oh,
need
wow.
a lot of space to build it, but that looks awesome. The signs on the fence gates.
Right.
So That's many cool. good details, you know?
So many cake points.
Like really good blend of grays and the browns in this kind of stone texture.
This little
here.
Cliffside, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, you know what I just saw that I really like? Campfire slab campfire. Gives off a really nice
there's just a very subtle like little arch there
yeah this is
I
a
give
really
this so
good
many
plot
cakes.
Ad yeah give it a big cakes you know
so That's much inspiration
definitely yes okay so we got Latissimus here or Lat fantastic build. I'm getting like some slight cyberpunky vibes from it. I don't know,
like
The roof doesn't speak to me in a cyberpunk way, but that's maybe it's just a cool freaking roof, you know?
It
but
is a cool freaking roof. I'll give it that.
Yeah.
It's like a fantasy Ooh. Build made. Yeah,
medieval X cyberpunk. Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to get across here. Yeah, it's and I love this little boat down here too. This is so cool.
Yeah, that's
little,
the speed boat.
Particles
it's
behind
so
it.
Good. Lapis here.
Uh-oh. There's no terraforming under the water.
There's no terraforming under the water.
Uh-oh.
Big no. Uh-oh.
All right. We'll give you
Scandal.
Five blueberries. Water pump.
Oh, have you seen this? Come over here.
It's a motorcycle.
It's a vroom vroom motorcycle, man.
Vroom vroom.
Yeah. We give it many cakes, but not infinite because of the water issue here.
We don't.
I don't mind it. We need terraforming. All right, we're moving on to this. This is by Zabarion.
Yeah,
Zabarion.
Okay. Zabarion.
Zabarione. What do you feel when you look at this?
I don't know. I feel peaceful. Just like a peaceful, nice little oriental style cottage up on the hill. Oh, it's lovely.
These lanterns here are so good.
They are so good.
Overall, for this, what I think is super cool is that it's like on a wonky diagonal.
It's very subtle.
It's a very subtle diagonal, and I think they pulled it off, especially with a roof this complex. Like the roof
yeah.
kind of ties together in the two different stages of the roof and
yeah.
has some interesting shapes to it. And they pulled it off perfectly, even with this weird little diagonal here. So big props for that, honestly.
I feel like I don't see this style that often.
I feel like it's
yeah.
very rarely done in the kind of more diagonally organic way. It's very often done on like a grid, you know? But did you see these hidden, hidden little note blocks behind.
Nope. That's hidden note blocks. That's a nice touch. So I good. Like it.
Let's give this one tons of cakes. So here we have a really good plot that unfortunately doesn't have like a what I would define as a structure on it.
Right.
It doesn't have a house or an igloo or a tower or a big flying right. airship. It's just terraforming, you know? But this plot,
very nice.
What I really like is this kind of mangrovey jungle swamp vibe yes. we got over here.
Oh, this is wonderful. The drip leaf in here too, the azalea.
I
also really like this little like kind of shafty thing over here, like little mine shafty.
Yeah,
that's mountain cool. climbing thing. It's pretty
like
neat.
Scaffolding situation.
Yeah, I give it like five. Six. Yeah. Cake. What's he doing?
Everybody's drinking water in my ear.
Oh, run. Get out of here.
Get out of here. This plot over here is, of course, by Ash, who? Fellow afterlifer to you.
Who is it? I don't know who that is.
That's unfortunate.
Yeah, I've never talked to him ever in my life. Before,
I think he's right there, right in front of us.
Oh,
Ash, okay. could you have gone bigger? Ash,
could you have done any more?
I think this hasn't really got enough stuff. Yeah, this is insanely cool. What the coolest part to me about this plot? There's so much to take in, but the coolest part is how like you're not really sure where the terrain stops and the buildings start, and everything is kind of very dynamically placed. Yeah, all meshed together. Yeah. we do love the big cogs. I'm a big fan of the big cogs. Mm-hmm. They're really cool.
The giant tree too is just with the moss blocks in the tree. I love that effect.
Oh yeah, that looks awesome. It's a fallen really, tower. Yeah.
And it's just and dangling kinda, by the tree.
He's kind of leaning on the big cog right there, dangling by the tree.
Tree is sort of like growing through it.
Also,
very nice
water runny effects here on the big cog. Mm-hmm. We like that.
Yeah, we like that. Well, you know us builders. We don't do interiors.
We don't do interiors. Yeah, this is just seriously really good. Loving all this kind of the variations of turquoise in this. It's definitely like a lot of turquoise, but they make it work. Mm-hmm. I feel like Mojang really, really likes like cyan and turquoise.
Yeah.
They're always adding blocks with that, like in that
It's range. A nice color. I like it.
It is, but you know.
Many cakes, well, many cakes, yeah, Ash.
Many
well
cakes, Ash. Moving on to the next one. This is Some Call Me Tim.
Someone call Tim, please.
Someone call Tim. Over here. get over here, Tim. This is really nice. I remember he was one of the first people that got on here to build, but this is one big cliff. Like, it's really cool.
Yeah, this just looks like the water levels rise and just like erode away at this cliff ever so slightly. That's what it
like
looks like.
Big tides or something like that.
Yeah.
You know?
And this house is just about to fall off of this cliff. it's so cool.
It's in the danger zone, all right. But this is a really cute house. I like the banners on the side there. Really
I didn't
nice.
Even notice like how he's using like copper as the foundation. That's pretty.
Oh, I didn't
that's
even
a
think
bold
about
move.
That. Yeah, that's a bold.
That's
move.
A bold move. It's a bold move, but it works.
It Holy. Works. It looks really cool.
Sorry.
Ooh, this is nice. Ooh, I love these shelves.
Oh, cool.
Ooh.
Many cakes. More cakes. Many.
Yeah, a lot of cakes. Tim has a parkour cave as well. Oh, snap. That's a lot of cakes. Yeah, well, I tried this one, and I just can't
oh, yeah,
make
we
the
can't
first
do
jump.
It. We can't do
I don't
do
understand
this.
How you make the first jump, honestly. What? How do you do a double jump? What is that? I don't
you
know.
You can't double jump in
no,
Minecraft.
This isn't friggin' Spider-Man. Then we're going over here, and this is a familiar person, Oz Turtle. This cool. is a castle. I'm gonna start by just walking through here.
Got rooted dirt on the ground. We love our dirt.
We love dirt. This is nice. I like these guys. Whatchamacallit? Like walkways.
Absolutely.
Yeah, this is just a really good castle. Like, I like the layout of it. I'm liking the different roofs that cover like sections mm-hmm. of the buildings, but not all of them. I really like the texturing here as well, and I like the addition of light gray concrete to the kind of stone.
Definitely a good gradient.
And also, look at these little bad boys. I've seen a lot of people use these, but the lightning rods, how good are
the
those?
The lightning rod.
Those
I mean,
are
they're,
so
they're
good.
Fantastic.
Well done,
Oz. Oh,
yeah.
Looks like
let's get
people have already put a lot of cakes.
Yeah, okay. I'm going to add one as well to the pile. This is I'm GP, also a member of the Afterlife server. This is just a really good build.
I mean, we could just disqualify him.
Why?
Just cause, why not? It'd be funny.
I really like the style here. The concept is really cool with all these. To me, it looks very much like ship parts that have been like repurposed
right.
and used as buildings.
And that's what, if that's what he's going for, that's, I mean, that's a hard effect to pull off for sure.
Yeah. It looks
not,
awesome.
That's not an easy thing to do. Very
like
cool.
The little turquoise nether sprouts and stuff here in the in the terrain. Good palm tree. Composters
palm
were
tree.
Made
well
for
done.
That.
Look at this, the raw gold ore mixed in the roof here.
Oh, that's awesome. To me, this is a very strong concept, right? This has a very strong theme, which is a little bit what we're looking for here in the contest. So,
very nice. Many cakes.
Many cakes.
All around.
All cakes all around. We have Legend Crafts. There's an About My Build section here. Do you want to check that out? Go number four. Thank you for hosting this build battle and giving us the opportunity to hang out and build with other creators. My build is a Japanese-style pagoda surrounded by cherry blossom trees. There's not much to explain, so enjoy. Can you find all the 10 presents?
Oh, so yes, let's do it.
Oh, you found one? There's supposed to
right
be
here.
10.
I found one.
Well done. You found one. Cherry trees are so good.
Mm-hmm. Like with the last one, this is a very strong theme as well over here.
Definitely.
You know? A lot of zen, tranquil feeling, so
definitely.
Very cool. Look at this. It's like the cherry blossoms come off the tree.
Oh, yeah. That's some good detail.
Oh, so good.
You know what? I think the moss block adds so much. It's so nice to have another, like an extra, it's like an extra grass block. So you can kind of vary the grass, you know?
Nice. Let's drip. See. I like the drip.
Yeah.
As a wallpaper.
The drip stone is good. Here we go.
Oh, beehives in the floor. I love it.
I love the looms in the bookshelf. Ooh, loving the vegetation in the roof here.
Oh,
what's
this block? Daylight detectors.
Daylight detectors? Cool.
What? You're a genius.
That's genius.
Wow. Inspiration.